like, so I'm sitting on my block. If you don't have block, just fold the blankets, maybe just fold the blankets few layers and sit on it. So you want to feel that your hips higher than the knees. So the lower back will be very comfortable. And let's lengthen from the base of the spine upwards. And then from the hips to your armpits, inhale, lift your arms, take your shoulders back and relax your shoulder blades, flat on your upper back, hands on your thighs, thumb and finger connected, if that's comfortable for you. Or place your palms facing down, that's also good, so whatever suits you. Let's check the neck, chin level, back of the head moving slightly back to elongate your neck. Close your eyes. And just notice your whole body, your whole posture. And we start with a few deep breaths. Inhaling deep into the abdomen, middle chest, upper chest. And as you exhale, exaggerate. Draw your tummy muscles in, exhale fully. And again, inhale, soften your tummy and expand. And as you exhale, hug your tummy muscles in, draw your belly button in, exhale, 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 and again, inhale and expand. Exhale, draw your tummy muscles in, and so on. Keeping your breath deep, flowing, enjoyable. We try to use whole capacity of the lungs, feel the expansion as you're breathing in, expansion of the ribcage to the front, to the sides, to the back of the ribcage. And as you exhale, keep your sternum and your clavicle bones lifted. Keeping the shoulder blades flat on your upper back. Neck is soft. We use deep breath to calm the mind, to calm the nervous system. Deep breath helps us to focus and we bring more oxygen. That's very important. Healing and anti-inflammatory oxygen into all the systems, the whole body, to every cell of the body. That's very important. Healing and anti-inflammatory oxygen. Remind yourself about your intention. We all have intentions. Your intention can be very small or very big. Your intention can be just for this yoga class or for a day, for a few days ahead. And if you are in doubt, ask yourself how you committed to yourself. How you committed to yourself and to your health. And find the inspiration in your answer. Keep your breath deep and flowing. On your next inhale, open your eyes, then relax your arms and your legs and come on your all fours. So move the block or the blanket to the sides and come on your all fours and we do cut and become straight. You have hands beneath your shoulders, knees beneath the hips and your toes under. As you inhale, straight forward, arms moving forward and the hips moving back. We want to lengthen through the sides and then soften between your shoulder blades. Inhale and look up. And as you exhale next, chin to your chest and round. Inhale, abdomen down, lift your heart between your arms, look upwards, and again, exhale and round. Inhale, lifting your heart and your tailbone, look up, exhale and round. We do twice more. Inhale, look up, nice and gentle move. Just to start to warm up the back, the shoulders, the hips. Make your last round, inhale, look up, exhale, and round. And then bring your back parallel to the floor in neutral position. And we're going to come up to down facing dog, So for down facing dog, I want you to take your knees slightly back away from the hips. Squeeze your arms, hands, arms and your shoulders, squeezing towards each other. With the strong arms and strong shoulders, lift your hips high and push the thigh bones back. And then do squat walking a few times. Bend your right knee and then the left knee and do that a few times. You start to stretch the back of the legs. And for your arms and your shoulders, I want you to squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders towards each other. Keep your shoulders strong, shoulder blades drawing towards the midline. And squat walk. You know you can stop anytime. If it's too much for your wrists, you can stop anytime. On your next inhale, come up high on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees, engage your tummy muscles and walk towards your hands. Walk into your forward bend, bend knees, that's fine. If you can't straighten your legs with ease, that's okay, bend your knees. Squeeze your legs down, look at your feet parallel, hips width apart or widen. Squeeze the legs. Let's take one hand at the lower back and check which way your pelvis is tipping forward or back. So if your pelvis tips forward, that's very good for the lower back. So you have your lower back comfortable. If your pelvis tips back, especially when you start to straighten your legs, so I suggest bend your knees forward and just try to tip that pelvis forward and forward to keep your lower back happy. Knees bent, okay. Squeeze the legs, take your hands to the hips. Lift your elbows, lift your shoulders, lift your chin, squeeze the legs stronger and come up with a straight back. Squeeze, 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 squeeze your legs, squeeze your legs, squeeze your legs, and then come up. Exhale, relax your arms. And let's just roll the shoulders, loosen up. Okay, well done. So now keep your feet like that, hips width apart, your feet parallel. Put a little shoulder stretch to the side. Inhale, lift your arms, hold your right wrist. Stretch up and then pull yourself to the left. Stretch, stretch. And it doesn't matter how far you go. Squeeze the legs, pull your belly button in, tummy muscles engage. Keep your tummy muscles strong and stretch and stretch. And if it's okay with you, with your balance, maybe you can step back with your right foot. Okay, and go a little bit deeper into the side stretch. But don't worry, you just can keep your feet flat here. Beginners maybe start with this option. On your next inhale, come back. Squeeze the legs, lift. Let's relax arms. Okay, relax your shoulders. And then we change side. Just roll your shoulders, soften, soften, soften. Well done. Inhale, stretch. Now hold your left wrist, lengthen, and then pull yourself to the right. Again, strong legs, squeeze the legs, tummy muscles in. You're squeezing the legs towards the midline or towards each other. And stretch, stretch. And if this is enough, just enjoy the breath and enjoy the stretch. Or if that's okay, step back with your left. Okay, and stretch a little bit more to the right. Close your core muscles, pulling your tummy muscles in. Great, and then come back. Inhale, lift. Exhale, relax your arms. And just roll your shoulders again. And maybe just give your arms a little shake, your legs a little shake. Okay, so we do another forward bend. I just want to show you first, again, just remind you how to look look after your lower back. So this is what we're doing. We're going to take feet very wide as your yoga mat. If you're on your yoga mat, we'll just take your feet very, very wide. And we're going to do this. Inhale and lengthen. Exhale with the knees bent, moving the hips back. You're going to fold. So see my back? My back is straight and I'm going to fold. Touching the floor, if you feel okay, that's too far to the floor. Maybe you have a block here or your book, and you do this. Inhale and stretch, keeping this length. Exhale, squeeze the legs, and you're going to bow over your legs. Okay, and don't worry to straighten your legs. We're going to keep knees bent, and we're going to do it again. Inhale, stretching forward. Exhale, squeeze the legs and bow. Relaxing your neck and your shoulders. And when you come back from the posture, you're going to squeeze the legs stronger, elbows lifted, shoulders, lift your chin. And again, we're going to try to keep the back straight when you come up. Okay, so let's do it together. Take your feet very wide. Yeah, and then bend your knees forward. Push the hips back. Okay, so and your knees moving back, the hips moving back. Inhale, and as you exhale, tummy muscles strong, fold. And we're going to keep the knees bent. Knees bent, touch the floor. Maybe you can touch the floor or grab the block if you need it or if you have it. Inhale, straight forward, lengthen away from the hips, thigh bones moving back. Exhale and bow. And we do it again. Inhale, straight forward, back straight, knees bent. I know legs working very hard here. Exhale and bow, relaxing your neck. And again, inhale on your finger pads and stretch. Exhale, bow a little deeper, relaxing your neck and your shoulders. We do twice more if that's okay. Inhale and stretch. Legs wide, knees bent. Exhale and bow. We do it last round. Inhale, straight forward. Exhale, squeeze your feet in your shins and bow. Now keep your legs steady. Take your hands to the hips. Squeeze the legs towards the midline. Lift your elbows, shoulders, lift your chin and come up. Inhale, lift. Well done. And then exhale, relax your arms. Bring your feet a little closer. Shake your legs. Relax, relax, relax. Well done, everyone. Come to the front of your mat. So we do. So what we do? We do a little sequence with the warrior postures. Sequence and salutation to the sun. And we're going to add warrior postures into that sequence. And also we're going to check the balance. We're going to just try to balance on one leg. Okay, so come to the front of the mat. Okay. Take space between your feet, hips width apart, your feet parallel. Okay, take your hands to your heart. And let's check how's your posture with the hips. Hips above your ankles. If your hips in front of your ankles, lift your toes upwards. Move the groins back, move the hips back. Keep your hips there above your ankles. Lengthen the tailbone, tummy in, shoulders back, back of the head back. So you want to feel that the crown of the head above your shoulders, shoulders above the hips, and your hips above your ankles. This is our Tadasana or mountain pose. Let's take a deep breath in. Lift your sternum, keep your heart lifted. Exhale, relax your arms. Inhale, let's stretch up. Gentle back bend or just stretching upwards. And as you exhale, forward bend, bend your knees again if you need. Beginners definitely bend your knees. Inhale on your finger pads and stretch forward. Lengthen away from the hips. Exhale, bow. Now move your hands by the side of your heels and step back with your right. Right foot back, high leg lunge or knee down. Beginners, if you want to take it easy, back knee down on the floor. We're going to squeeze the legs. Lift your chest, take a deep breath. And then exhale, stepping back into the plank or half plank. Plank with straight legs, if that's okay with you. Or half plank, going with the knees down, half plank, beginners, maybe this is you. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders, tummy engaged. Look straight, inhale, and as you exhale, knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows, lie down on your tummy. Then point your toes back and check head and shoulders lifted. Lengthen the tailbone, come up to raise cobra, shoulders down, buttocks soft, lower back is happy. Do the double chin, maybe lift your chin a little. Inhale, and as you exhale, drag your hands back, lengthen and stretch forward. Toes under, down facing dog, or come on your all fours, and then down facing dog. Lifting your sitting bones high, push the thigh bones back, heels down, have a good stretch, extend and stretch through the whole back of the body. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, look between your hands, right leg up and step forward. Beginners, maybe you want to bring your knees down and then step forward with your right. Even helping with your hand is good. And we're all going to check front knee above your front ankle, checking that. Good position for your knee. Squeeze the legs, lift your chest, take a deep breath in. And then step forward into your forward bend. Squeeze your legs, knees bent, okay. Press down with your feet and come up. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, hands to your heart. And check you are in the front of the mat, so you have space behind you to step. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale and stretch up. Exhale, forward bend. Bend your knees again if you need. Touch the floor or your legs. Inhale, stretch forward. Exhale, bow. Hands by the side of your heels. Step up with your left. High leg lunge or knee down. Choose your option. Deep breath in, deep breath into your chest, lift your chest. And then step back into the plank or half plank. Beginners, maybe you want to go for the half plank again, knees down, or maybe you can straighten your legs, squeeze your arms, deep breath. Exhale, knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows, lie down, point your toes back, and slow come up to raise cobra, lengthening the tailbone, come up, shoulders down, double chin to keep the back of the neck long, maybe lift your chin a little, inhale, and as you exhale, drag your hands back, lengthen and stretch forward, shoulders lifted, toes under, down facing dog, or come on your fours. Squeeze your arms, press down with your finger pads and stretch your hips up, thigh bones back, heels down. This is your down facing dog. Try to press your all finger pads into the floor stronger. On your next inhale, come up on your tiptoes, look between your hands. Left leg up and step forward. Or if you feel you stop somewhere between, help with your hand. Bring that left foot forward, back where you started. Take a deep breath. Do you need to lower that back knee? Beginners, maybe you need to squeeze your legs. Deep breath in. Step into your forward bend. Space between your feet. Hips width apart or wider. Squeeze the legs. Press down with your feet and come up. Inhale, lift. Salute to the sun. Exhale, hands to your heart. Take a deep breath. Let's check the balance. Okay, let's check the balance. This way I'm going to start facing you for now. So move the weight of your body to your right. I'm going to be nearer to your right. Okay, can you lift? I'm going to be nearer, just reminding myself. Moving the weight to the right. Can you lift your left knee and can you hold it? Okay, flex your foot, spread your toes. Okay. At this moment, if you need to hold the wall, come to the wall, hold with one finger. Okay, take a moment, just checking your balance. Can you stand on one leg? Tummy engaged. Okay, let's change. Okay, let's change another leg. Okay, can you lift your right knee, hold your right knee or the back of your right thigh? Squeeze the hips, your tummy muscles engaged. Take a moment. Maybe look straight ahead. Just find that point straight ahead. Look at that point. Great. And then relax. Give your legs a little shake. Shake, shake, shake. And again, come to the front of your mat. Okay. Let's try again this little balance. So moving the weight of your body to the left. And we're going to hold the right knee. Can you hold your right knee? Just take a moment here. Okay. Well done. Holding your right knee. Now, we're going to take that right foot back, stepping back, very big step. So very, very big step. Okay, so we're going to warrior one pose. Okay, Rachel, who's pregnant, don't try to step back far. Just a comfortable step back. Okay, and we're going to take feet a little wider. So there's a space for the hips and the lower back. Lift your chest, lengthen the tailbone, tummy muscles engaged. Inhale and stretch your arms. So this is option for warrior one. This is one option, beginners. Maybe this is just your option. Or can you lift your back heel off the floor and go for the high leg lunge? Maybe even sit a little lower, taking the back of the waistline back, shoulders back, arms, thumbs, keep straightening away from the hips with the very strong legs. Look into the corner of the ceiling if you can. Deep breath into your chest, inhale, and as you exhale, bring your hands to the hips and to lower your back heel to the floor. Okay, so now watch me for a moment. I'm just going to skip my legs, okay, and we're going to do this. We're going to go into the warrior two pose. So you're going to come up and stretch your arms to the sides, warrior two pose, and look at your front foot and just move so that front heel in line with the middle of your back and step. So take a deep breath here. So you are in the warrior two. From warrior one, we move to warrior two. Engage your core muscles. Now we're going to do sun warrior. Okay, one arm down and stretch your left arm up, look up, deep breath. And then come back to the middle, warrior two.
We got to stretch forward, full extended side stretch, elbow to your knee, right arm over the head, and maybe even a look up above the elbow. I'm going to come back. Inhale, come back. And again, Sun Warrior. Right arm down, left arm up. Deep breath. Inhale, come back to the middle. Extended side stretch. Stretch forward, elbow to your knee. And your other arm over the head. And again, maybe look up above the elbow. Exhale, look down. Come up standing. Can you do again warrior one pose? Take your hands to the hips, it's easier. Okay, and turning the hips forward. Maybe going again for the high leg lunge or keeping your foot down. Deep breath. And then looking down and we're going to try to touch the floor and going back to down facing dog. Can you reach the floor? But don't worry if this is not for you. Yeah, and then step back again to down facing dog and have a good stretch. Lifting the sitting bones high, thigh bones back, heels down. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, bring your knees down to the floor. Squeeze your arms and your shoulders, bend your elbows back and lie down on your tummy. Point your toes back. We're going to come up to raised cobra, gently lengthening the tailbone. Inhale, come up. It doesn't matter how far, shoulders down. With a double chin, maybe lift your chin a little, inhale. And as you exhale, keep pressing your legs into the floor and stretch forward, away from the hips. Toes under, push back to down facing dog or come on your fours, and then down facing dog, deep breath. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees and walk towards your hands, into your forward bend. Bend your knees if you need, and that's okay to bend your knees in the forward bend. Squeeze the legs, listen to your lower back, press down with your feet and come up. Inhale and stretch, exhale, hands to your heart, take a deep breath, and we're going to do all the same on the other side. So moving the weight of your body to your left. Okay, I'm going to be your mirror now. Okay, and holding your other knee. Just take a moment here. And we're going to step back. So take a moment. And when you let go of that leg, you're going to step back. Stepping back. Big step. Okay, did we change legs? I'm just sort of... Okay, I did the other leg for you. Oh, changing legs, guys. Okay, I'm going to go on the other side. So we're going to step back with the left, yeah, left foot back. I'm going on the other side to be your mirror. So left foot back. I'm stepping back with my right. Okay, and bend your front knee. Okay, so we're going into the warrior one pose. So the hips facing forward for the warrior one, lengthening the tailbone. Inhale and stretch your arms. Maybe go for the high leg lunge with your heel lifted or keep your foot flat on the floor. That's okay. Deep breath. Cause your core muscles, let's engage tummy muscles a little bit more, lengthening the tailbone and stretching away from the hips. Deep breath in. You can hear my cuckoo clock. And as you exhale, bring that back foot on the floor flat. And going for warrior two pose. Check your front heel in line with the middle of your back and step. Okay, so this is your warrior two pose. You want to check your front knee above your front ankle. Deep breath. And as you exhale, bring your left arm down, right arm up, and stretch. This is your sun warrior pose. And then come back to the middle, extended side stretch. Stretch it forward, elbow to your knee, and your arm over the head. Have a good side stretch, maybe even look up above the elbow. And then look down and come back, warrior two. Again, sun warrior. Inhale and stretch, take a deep breath into the right side of the rib cage. And then come back, extended side stretch, lengthening elbow on your knee, other arm over the head, look up, deep breath, and then coming back to warrior two, hands on the hips. We're going to turn the hips now facing to the front of the mat. Okay, warrior one pose. Again, lift your back heel, make space between your feet. If you can go for the high leg lunge, go for it. Okay, straighten your arms upwards. Warrior one, lengthening. And as you exhale, look down. Can you touch the floor with your hands? Can you reach the floor? And then step back to down facing dog. Let's have a good stretch and down facing dog. Press all finger pads into the floor. Push the thigh bones back, heels down. Deep breathing. Engage in your tummy muscles. And then think about your plank or half plank. Choose your option again. Don't worry to do everything. If you feel plank is too much, knees down, squeeze your arms and your shoulders. Deep breath, look straight. And as you exhale, knees, elbows, or maybe you can lean forward, then bend your elbows, lie down, point your toes back, check your shoulders lifted, lengthen the tailbone and come up. Now moving your shoulders down away from your ears, doing double chin, lift your chin a little, inhale. And as you exhale, drop your hands back, lengthen and stretch forward. Keep your shoulders lifted, toes under, down facing dog again, or come on your fours, and then stretch into your down facing dog. Push the hips high, stretch your thigh bones back, heels down. Press all finger pads into the floor. Try to avoid standing on your wrists, more energy on your finger pads. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees and walk towards your hands into your forward bend. Make space between your feet, hips width apart or wider, listen to your lower back. Squeeze the legs, press down with your feet and come up. Inhale and lift. Salute to the sun. Exhale, hands to your heart. Take a deep breath. And then relax your arms. Okay, relax your shoulders. Okay, so next we do another standing posture. This is a balance pose called warrior three pose. I give you options. I show you classical variation and then I give you modification for beginners and also for Rachel who's pregnant. So this is your classical options. Looks like that. Inhale, straighten upwards. And as you exhale, you're going to take one heel back and keep stretching forward, stretching forward, stretching forward. So this is the warrior three pose. So if you feel, okay, this is too much and balance is a bit challenging today, you can take a chair. I'm going to grab my chair now. You can take a chair. Or you can come closer to the table. So this is my chair. Okay. And you can place your hands on the table, on the back of the chair. You step away and you can do all the same. You just have this little support. So you straighten toes, you straighten your back first, engage your tummy muscles, and you just take one leg back, keeping the hips level, and you stay here. So this is a very nice option for beginners. So if you feel you need the chair or come to the table, please do. Okay, please do. We're going to try to balance here with on one leg. Okay, let's do it together. Stretch your arms upwards if you're doing freestanding or you already placed your hands on the back of the chair and you step back. Now we're going to move the weight of the body to the left foot. Engage your tummy muscles and let's pivot forward if you do freestanding and we're going to press that heel, right heel back. Flex your foot, right heel back. Squeeze the hips, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze the hips. Straight forward, right heel pushing back. Try to straighten that standing leg and breathe. Squeeze the hips, find your balance. Okay, anytime when you feel you need to stop, please do. Deep breathing and then come back. You're not going to stay for long. Inhale, come back. Exhale, relax your arms, give your legs a little shake. Shake, shake, shake. Okay, we're going to change sides. We're going to do twice on each side. So let's do another leg. Stretching upwards. Moving the weight of the body now to the right. Flex your left foot and you push your left heel back. Okay, stretch, back, stretch, stretch, stretch. Rachel, you're using the chair. Maybe it's better for you to place your hands on the chair and stretch. Okay, deep breathing. Look somewhere straight ahead or somewhere into the corner of the floor, on the floor. And we're going to come back. Inhale, come back. Exhale, relax. I know it's quite strong, challenging. You might even get sweaty. Yeah, I'm started to sweat now. We do second round. Okay, second round. Inhale. Exhale, moving the weight to the left. Flex your right foot and push the heel back. Squeeze the hips and keep stretching, 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 stretching forward. Lengthening forward. Think about your right heel. Push that heel back. Tummy muscles very strong. Deep breathing. And then come back. Inhale. Exhale. Relax your arms. Give your legs a little shake. Relax your shoulders. Keep your neck soft. Great, everyone. Moving to the other side. Inhale. Exhale. Flex that left foot. Push the heel back. And it doesn't matter how far you go. Okay, use the chair. Back of the chair. Just place your hands on the table. Balancing on one side. Push the heel back and back and back and back. Squeeze the hips. Help your core muscles. Lift, lift, lift your tummy muscles up. Lovely, everyone. And then come back. Inhale. Exhale. Relax your arms. Okay. Roll your shoulders. Keep your neck soft. Okay, great. We're going to sit on the floor. Let's do squat and then sit on the floor from the squat. Watch your knees. Listen to your body. If you feel this is a bit too much for my knees, you can stop halfway and just have a little break there. Okay, I'm going to stand this way to you. Stretch your arms in front. Inhale. And as we exhale, going halfway, pushing the hips back, just halfway. And just checking how you feel here. How's your knees doing? How's your hips back? Very strong tummy muscles. Then come back. Okay, relax your arms. I'm going to give you a tip. For sensitive knees, lift your toes upwards. What happens here when we lift the toes? We engage all the shin muscles, which supports our knees better. So keep that. I often do that. Even sometimes I don't need support for my knees, but that gives me a little bit more support and steadiness. I feel quite rooted in this posture. Okay, let's stretch arms. Inhale. Going halfway, push your hips back. Keep your tummy muscles engaged. Okay, maybe this is just enough. You can stop. Breathe here. Or can you go just a little lower? Just a little lower. We're going to come back again, tummy in. Inhale. Exhale, relax. Just give your legs a little shake. And the next, if you're happy to go all the way down, we're going to sit on the floor. Inhale. Exhale, push the hips back, toes up. You can try with your toes upwards. It's quite steady. Yeah, I feel very steady when my toes active. And if you're very low, bring your hands together. With your elbows, take your knees a little wider apart. Take a moment here. Very strong tummy muscles. Lift all the tummy muscles up. Your pelvic floor muscles lifting. Strong legs, strong core muscles. And if you're very happy here and you can sit on the floor, if you're very low, hold the floor. One hand in front, one hand behind, and then sit on the floor. Maybe this is okay. Or come up and then sit in your fashion way. Okay, I can sit easily like so. Okay, maybe you need to come up and sit. Okay, well done. And then relax your legs. Give your legs a little shake. Shake, shake, shake. Let's have a drink, everyone. Quite strong practice today. You might feel a little bit hot or maybe even sweaty. I just want to say, Rachel, who's pregnant, you shouldn't sweat during yoga. So just do very comfortably, be very, very comfortable. Okay, just checking on my screen. Okay, Rachel, show me thumbs. Yep, that's it, well done. No sweating for you, you just take it easy. Okay, great. Then watch me for a moment. I want to show you posture where you might need a block. So we're going to do, as you sideways to you this way, we're going to do a side stretch and a forward bend. Side stretch looks like that. We're going to take one heel in. If this knee is not happy, you can straighten your leg to the side. And if you feel quite tight on your hips and you need support here for your hand, you can use block. Again, if you have block, but don't worry if you don't, you can use the block, the book, or again, just maybe that folded blanket here will help you just rest your hand there. Okay, I'm going to use this block. And I show you first, this is demonstration, very fast. Inhale, Hansen. Exhale, we're going to slide hand closer to that foot. Or maybe block here if you need it. And you can stop here with the other arm upwards. Or if you can, slide your hand closer, closer, closer. Another option, hooking that big toe with your thumb and maybe even taking your arm over the head. Then we're going to come back. We're going to turn to that front foot. And we go into the forward bend. Okay, let's try. I'm your mirror. So bend your right leg, point your toes, and take your right heel into the groin if that's okay with your right knee. How's that? Is that okay? Or do you need to straighten your leg to the side? You can do that also. Okay, I'm going to show you this option. You block or hold the blanket here for your hand if you can't reach the floor with ease. If you can reach the floor, that's fine. Okay, let's do this. Looking at that right knee, one hand in front, one hand behind. We want to press into the floor and lengthen. Now keeping that length, folding over that front leg, we're walking your finger butts forward. So that left hand walking forward, right shoulder back, stop again and again, inhale, lengthen, exhale, begin to fold. Okay, and maybe stretch that right arm upwards. Maybe you can hook your big toe with your thumb on your left side and breathe again. Inhale, lengthening through the sides of the body, lengthen, exhale and fold. It doesn't matter how far you go. And again, inhale and stretch, exhale, fold. Beginners, if you just want to stop here and keep stretching, very good. Keep lengthening. We're going to stretch that right side and the left. We don't forget about the left. Lengthening, stretching, maybe even look up. Okay, deep breath. Take another deep breath. And then come back. Inhale, come back. Quite strong side stretch. Now turn your shoulders and look at that front foot, looking at your left foot. Hands behind you. Inhale and stretch. Again, think about the length. Keep that length. Fold over your front leg. We're going to reach towards that front foot. Again, inhale, stretch. Exhale, lengthening forward. Okay, looking at your front foot. Can you hold your front foot with one hand? Okay, another hand on the floor. Using your arms to lengthen, like sort of wiggle, wiggle from through the sides. Soften between your shoulder blades. Maybe you can hold your foot with two hands, but don't worry. You can do this middle option. Or beginner's variation, pressing into the floor and stretching forward, lengthening, lengthening, lengthening. And again, inhale, stretch, exhale, fold. Lots of options for you. Please do choose which is appropriate. On your next inhale, come back. Inhale, come back. Stretch your both legs. Give your legs a little shake. Shake, shake, shake. And then we change sides. Okay, let's change. Left leg, bend your left, point your toes, take your heel into the groin, and again, check how that left knee doing. Do you need just to stretch your leg? You can do that. You can do with both legs straight. Okay, I'll do this option. Looking at your bent knee, one hand in front, one hand behind. Inhale, exhale, folding above that front leg. walking your hand forward, your right hand forward and forward towards your right foot. Let's take that left shoulder back. Left shoulder back, open your chest, lift your chin, maybe look up at the ceiling. And again, inhale, lengthening, exhale, folding. Can you stretch your left arm up towards the ceiling first? Just check how you feel, open your chest, deep breath. And again, inhale, lengthening, exhale, folding. Hook your big toe with your thumb, if that's appropriate. And maybe take your left arm over the head, reaching towards your front foot. And the same breath, inhale, stretch, exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, fold. The top shoulder is still moving back, giving you the great stretch on the side. So this is seated side stretch. Lovely stretch for the shoulders, for the side, for the hip. On your next inhale, come back. Great. Now forward bend, turning shoulders towards your right foot. Oh, sorry, that's it. Your right, my left. Trying to be a mirror and trying not to confuse myself. Okay, take your hands behind. Inhale and stretch. And as you exhale, the heart reaching forward. And again, inhale, lengthen, keeping the length and folding over your front leg. Look at your front heel. Can you press that heel down into the floor? That's it. Keep your leg working. Maybe you can hold your foot with one hand or maybe two hands. And so on. Inhale, stretching. Exhale, carry your heart forward. And again, inhale, lengthening. Exhale, carry your heart forward. Maybe you can do two hands, but don't worry. You don't have to do everything. Press that front leg into the floor stronger. Press, press, press. So you have good extension, good stretch. Deep breathing still. Well done. On your next inhale, come up. Inhale. Come up. Lean back. Stretch your both legs to the front. And give your legs a little shake. Just relax, relax, relax. Well done, everyone. That was good. Very strong forward bend and a side stretch. So now we're going to try to ease the back in Padakonasana or the cobbler pose. So this is where I want you to sit again on your yoga block or on a folded blanket. So take the blanket if you don't have yoga block and sit on it. Okay, sit on it. And this is a nice and gentle back release, hip release. Okay, feet together. And I'm going to look at the feet. Spread your toes a lot. Okay, so and you have four corners of the feet pressing against each other. I'm just going to remind you, so this is four corners. Big toe joint pad, little toe joint pad, inside of the heel and outside of the heel. So we're going to think about those four corners pressing against each other. Press, press, press. Toes active, just look at your toes, spread your toes, toes active. And you hold your shins just above your ankle joints. Inhale and lengthen. And as you exhale, engage your tummy muscles. I'm going to stay here for a moment. And again, inhale and lengthen. Exhale, engage your tummy muscles. And if you have that easy space to fold forward from the hips, just thinking about the chest reaching forward. Okay, and again, inhale, lengthening. Exhale, tummy engaged, still reaching forward. Okay, well done. Elbows a little wider. Great. Press your elbows into your legs, legs into your elbows, and keep reaching forward and forward. Squeeze your feet against each other. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. On your next inhale, come back and relax your legs. Give your legs a little shake. Relax, relax, relax. And we do it again. Okay. We do it again. Bring your feet together. Four corners of the feet pressing against each other, holding your shins above your ankle joints. Inhale and lengthen. Exhale again, tummy muscles engaged and reaching forward. And it doesn't matter how far you go. You might feel, okay, I don't have space to fold forward. I just want to stay here straight and that's okay. Use your breath. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, tummy in, fold forward.
maybe elbows wide, press your elbows into your legs, legs into your elbows. You feel the engagement of the inner thighs. This is a good thing. Engaging the inner thighs and moving your thigh bones back, relaxing the neck. Very strong legs. If you look at your feet again, just check four corners of the feet pressing against each other. Thigh bones moving back and wider apart, creating more space for the back of the pelvis, more space for the lower back. On your next inhale, come back and relax your legs. Give your legs a little shake again. Relax, relax, relax. Okay, well done everyone. So now would be very nice to do a little self-massage for the lower back. So I'll quickly show you what to do. If you want to lie down on the blanket for that, that's quite nice to have a blanket under your lower back and the hips. And you're going to do this. You're going to bring knees to your chest. You're going to rock from side to side. And then with each hand on your knees, you're going to rock and roll. Rolling one direction, then another direction. So let's do that a few times. So if you would like to lie down, Rachel, if you want to stay for 30 seconds on the back, that's fine. Or you can do cat and the cow stretch instead. Okay, so let's do that. I'm just going to check my phone just to remember it, that I didn't put my phone on silence. Okay, that's it. My phone is on silence. Okay, great. So let's carry on rocking and rolling. Okay, rocking and rolling a few times. Should feel nice for the back of the pelvis, for the lower back and the hips. Nice and gently. Few times. Okay, well done. I can see you on my screen, on my big screen. That's very good. Great. And then roll over to your right hand side. Very good. And watch me for a moment. So this is your screen wipers twist. So it would be very nice to do this after all this work. So feet, just notice my feet parallel, feet hips width apart, toes active, shoulder blades flat, and you're going to move your legs like so from side to side. So this is nice and gentle twist. So let's do that a few times. So again, lie down on your back. Okay. Feet hips width apart, toes active, and moving your legs from side to side, like a screen wipers, side to side. Okay, great, I'll do it with you. Okay. From side to side, nice and gently. I love this screen wipers twist. Gives you lots of space. And as we worked a lot with the back and the hips, this is lovely release. Easy breathing. And then come back to the middle. And then roll over to your right hand side and come up to the sitting. And I want you to find again folded blanket perhaps or your block and sit on it. We're going to do a breathing exercise. So, and you want to sit very comfortable again, like you did in the beginning of the class, with your back upright. Okay. We're going to do breathing exercise, nice and easy. Exercise, which one of my favorites, it's a stress buster. So we're going to use this mudra, special gesture on the hand, where you're going to place your thumb on your right nostril, ring finger on your left nostril, and these two fingers on your forehead. And you're going to do this. You're going to inhale through the right nostril, and then exhale through the left nostril. Inhale through the left nostril, exhale through the right nostril. And we're going to repeat that about six times. So sit comfortably with your back upright. And this is called alternative nostril breathing technique. So we're going alternatively to use one nostril at a time. So place your right palm on your right nostril, ring finger on your left nostril, place your index and your middle finger on your forehead, inhale through the right, exhale through the left. Inhale through the left nostril. Exhale through the right. I'll guide you once more. Again, inhale through the right. Exhale through the left. Inhale through the left. Exhale through the right. And keep breathing. Keep breathing. Inhaling through one nostril. Exhaling through the other nostril. Continue, keep breathing. One nostril at a time. And you probably notice that your breath is becoming slower and slower. Your thoughts becoming slower and calmer. Slow down. Relaxing and slowing down the breath. Relaxing the mind. Slowing down the thoughts. And let's do another round. Another round of this slow, deep breathing, alternative nostril breathing technique. And when you finish, you just place your hands on your thighs. Keep your eyes closed and notice the difference. Just notice the energy flow, your breath. And then next, we're going to relax. So I would like you to lie down on the floor or on your yoga mat and take your blanket with you, cover yourself with the blanket. So if you're not sure what posture looks like, it's called Shavasana, when you lie with your feet wider than the hips, arms to the sides, and you relax. Or cover yourself with the blanket. Stay warm and comfortable. Okay, so lie down, relax, be comfortable. Okay, let's sit Rachel on the side, that's very nice. And make sure you're very comfortable, you have blankets, blocks if you need. And let's check that whole posture. Press your hips into the floor and restore the lumbar space. Just notice there is a space between the lower back and your yoga mat.
Go ahead.
That's my Siri. Look up. Okay. Relax your shoulders. Relax the back of the head on the floor. Smile to relax your facial muscles. And relive the beginning of the smile on your face. Relax your breathing and slow down your breath. Just notice that natural flow of the air through your nostrils. Slightly cool air entering your nostrils on the inhalation. And slightly warm and moist air leaving your nostrils on the exhalation. Slow down your breath and absorb all the physical sensations in your body. Smile to relax your facial muscles. Leave the beginning of the smile on your face. Feel your forehead becoming wider and smoother.
relax your scalp, relax your ears, the skin beneath your ears, and relax your breathing again. With each breath becoming softer and more relaxed. Finding your own way to the still, calm center of your being, to a place of wholeness, completeness, and integrity. Slow down your breath, and remind yourself that you can use the breath to relax both the body and mind. Create the connection between the breath, the body, and mind. Steady breathing, calm and alert mind. Relax the body. And sometimes we lose that connection. And it's very useful sometimes during the day when you feel anxious or if you feel stressful to remind yourself about that connection. Connection between the body, your breath, and your mind. Steady breathing, calm and alert mind, relax the body. We create that sense of calmness during the relaxation. We restore and renew the energy when we rest in Shavasana. And if you would remember to use this knowledge, or to use this information and practice this Shavasana during the day when you feel very stressful or when the things get hard, take your time, create the space just to lie down and rest in Shavasana with your slow breath. Now, as your relaxation and short meditation comes to the end, bring your awareness back to your surroundings, back to the room you are in, to your friends, to your family next to you, to your pets next to you. Deepen your breath, extend your inhalations, exhalations, reawakening the energy in your body. And then slide your legs together, arms by the side of your body. Inhale and stretch. Take your arms over your head. Stretch the stretch away from the waistline. And when you feel sufficiently stretched, bend your knees to your chest. Just hug your knees with your hands. Gently rock from side to side. Reawakening the lower back. Very good. And then roll over to your right hand side. Just take a moment. Press into the floor with your hands. Come up to the sitting with your hands in Anjali Mudra in front of your heart. Okay. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Keep that length and just slightly lean back to feel the strong support of your back muscles. Support, steadiness of the universe. Reflect your practice. Reflect your intention of the practice. Notice how you feel. Enjoy extra strength, flexibility, and clarity of mind. Traditionally, we finish class with one gentle Om. Exhale first. Inhale. Om.
Bow your head to your heart, to the light within you, and open your eyes.